For today's video that is kindly sponsored by MSI, we'll be taking a look at a mainstream Intel Core Ultra motherboard that sports the new mid-range Intel B860 chipset, the MSI MAG B860M MORTAR WIFI. Let's get started. As an offering from the MAG series of products, this motherboard is a gamer-oriented mainstream offering from MSI's B860 motherboard lineup. For those of you who are unaware, the MAG lineup is effectively targeted at mainstream gamers, where the said lineup places below the performance-oriented MPG series of products as well as the top-of-the-line MEG series of enthusiast-class product offerings. As can be seen, the MAG B860M MORTAR WIFI comes in a grey box with green accents, and moving over to the rear, we get the usual overview of specs for this board. We'll run through these specs in detail later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest developments in the PC hardware world. With that, let's get on with it. In terms of accessories, MSI's included a Wi-Fi antenna in this box right here. And with that, let's set aside the board for now to have a look at the rest of the accessories that this board comes with. First up, we get a single SATA 3 cable. And this is accompanied by an easy front panel cable that helps make hooking up the front panel connectors of your PC case to the motherboard a breeze. Now we do also get a special 1-2 EasyCon cable, which is a new MSI-specific feature that allows end users to connect MSI's new Easy series of ARGB fans to the motherboard with just one connector so as to simplify things. I'll cover EasyCon in more detail later on in this video. Now we do also get two spare Easy M.2 Clip-2 attachments that facilitate the toolless installation and removal of your M.2 drives. These are also accompanied by an Easy M.2 Clip-2 remover tool. Now in terms of documentation, we get a quick installation guide right here. And this is accompanied by a regulatory information leaflet. And to round things off, a MSI survey leaflet. Here it is, the MSI MAG B860M MORTAR WIFI. We see that MSI has gone for a relatively clean aesthetic with a black colored PCB and large black heat sinks all around that feature lime green accents for a nice pop of color. Fans of RGB lighting effects might be disappointed to note that the board does not come with any onboard RGB LEDs, though it does of course come with an assortment of RGB headers, which I'll cover later on in this video. The board comes with an integrated I/O shield design with decently sized VRM heatsinks, and in terms of VRM specs, MSI has included 12+1+1+1 power stages with 60A DRMOS power phasors. The board comes with a passive heatsink for the B860 chipset, and for M.2 drive cooling, MSI's included heatsinks for two of the three M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. The rear of the motherboard is quite a standard affair, though we do get some markings that MSI calls case standoff keepout zones to serve as a warning not to install unneeded motherboard standoffs within your PC case, which could otherwise short-circuit the board, I suppose. MSI has also taken the liberty to include protective paint around the motherboard's screw holes so as to protect the PCB against scratches, which is a nice touch. For memory support, the MAG B860M MORTAR WIFI comes with 4 DDR5 slots that, as of the time of recording this video, comes with support for up to 256GB of RAM and the DDR5 9200 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single tab design. Near the bottom of the RAM slots is a USB 5GBPS front panel header that provides support for up to 2 USB 5GBPS Type-A ports, and further down, a USB 10GBPS Type-C front panel header. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers right here, with each header providing support for up to two USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Moving on to some of the special features that this board comes with, we get an 8-pin supplemental PCIe power connector that provides for an additional source of juice for the power-hungry flagship GPUs of tomorrow. According to MSI, the said connector can provide up to 252 watts of supplemental power. We do also get a Thunderbolt 5 expansion card header that is to be used with an optional MSI Thunderbolt 5 add-on card, a clear CMOS header right here, a tuning controller header that is to be used with an optional MSI tuning controller device, as well as a chassis intrusion header. MSI has also included a TPM header for an optional TPM module located here, as well as an EasyCon header. As mentioned earlier, EasyCon is a new MSI-specific connector, and it allows end users to easily connect MSI's next-generation ARGB fans to the motherboard with just one onboard connector. For end users who do not have such MSI ARGB fans, the EasyCon header can still be used with non-MSI devices via the included 1-to-2 EasyCon cable included with the motherboard, which, as can be seen, comes with an addressable RGB header and a 4-pin fan header. Moving up top, we get a set of easy debug LEDs that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot sports MSI's Steel Armor 2 design so as to reinforce the slot for use with heavy graphics cards. As can be seen, the slot also comes with the easy PCIe release feature that helps make removing a graphics card a painless affair. Pressing down on this button right here will undo the latch for the installation or removal of a graphics card, and we even get a little window that shows whether the latch is locked in place or not. Rounding off this section on expansion slots, we do also get a PCIe 4.0 X4 slot right here. In the storage department, MSI has included 4 SATA 3 ports, with 2 ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management, and 2 ports in a straight-angled configuration. Moving on to M.2 slots, the board comes with 3 M.2 slots, of which this first slot here supports the PCIe 5.0 X4 standard, while the remaining 2 slots support the PCIe 4.0 X4 standard. Do note that all of these slots support NVMe SSDs only. M.2 SATA drives will not work in any of these slots. Of the 2 M.2 heatsinks that the board comes with, the primary M.2 heatsink features a toolless design called Easy M.2 Shield Frozer 2, which makes removing and installing the heatsink really easy. All you've got to do is press down on the button located at the side of the heatsink and lift the heatsink away from the board. Another quality of life feature that the M.2 slots have is Easy M.2 Clip 2, which is a spring-loaded standoff device that makes installing and removing a M.2 drive a toolless affair, like so. We do also get an easy M.2 Clip 2 remover tool that comes in handy to remove and reposition the easy M.2 Clip 2 device so as to accommodate M.2 drives of different lengths apart from the standard 2280 form factor. Do note that the easy M.2 Clip 2 only comes pre-installed for the second M.2 slot. The first and third M.2 slots come pre-installed with the standard Easy M.2 Clip feature, and you can install the spare Easy M.2 Clip 2 standoffs if you're intending to use a M.2 drive shorter than the standard 2280 form factor with the first and third M.2 slots. For audio, MSI's gone for an entry-level Realtek ALC897 audio codec, while wired internet connectivity is courtesy of Intel's killer 5000B, which provides support for speedy 5 Gigabit Ethernet. The board's Wi-Fi is powered by an Intel killer BE1750X module that supports the latest Wi-Fi 7 standard and the 320 MHz channel width, all while providing support for Bluetooth 5.4 as well. In the cooling and RGB department, the board comes with 6 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 addressable RGB headers and a 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the MAG B860M MORTAR WIFI goes for an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 connector that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports display output of up to 8K resolution at 60Hz, a Thunderbolt 4 USB Type-C port that supports display output of up to 8K resolution at 60Hz and also supports 15 watts of power delivery for charging purposes. We do also get a flash BIOS button that allows end users to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card, a clear CMOS button, 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, of which this port here supports the flash BIOS feature, a USB 10Gbps Type-C port, 3 USB 10Gbps Type-A ports, a 5 Gigabit Ethernet port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. And with that, the MSI MAG B860M MORTAR WIFI shapes up to be a pretty well-specced Intel B860 motherboard offering, where it has plenty of features that actually matter, which allows it to rival even cheaper motherboards sporting the high-end Z890 chipset. We're talking about features such as a relatively beefy VRM setup, PCIe 5.0 support for a graphics card and an M.2 drive, Intel 5 Gigabit Ethernet and Intel Wi-Fi 7 as standard, and a whole bunch of nice quality of life features such as easy PCIe release, easy M.2 clip 2, and so on. All in all, if you're looking to build a mainstream micro ATX PC powered by Intel's Core Ultra series of processors, the MAG B860M MORTAR WIFI should definitely be on your radar. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.